Hello everyone, my name is Vijay Kumar and we are studying refrigeration and air conditioning. In the last video, I told about the aircraft refrigeration cycle. I have explained different types of aircraft refrigeration cycle. Now, in this video, we will study about DART, D-A-R-T. This DART is used to compare the cycle which I explained in my previous video. So let's start. What is DART? DART means dry air rated temperature. Dry air rated temperature. The full form of DART is this. Now, it is the temperature of the air at the exit of the cooling turbine. It is the temperature of the air at the exit of the cooling turbine in the absence of moisture condensation. That means at the exit of a turbine, there should not be a moisture content. There should not be any condensation. So let's see here. This is the TS diagram. I have explained these type of diagrams in my previous videos. In this, you know all the processes 1 to 2 dash, 2 dash to 3 dash, 3 dash to 4. You know very well. We will concentrate here 4 to 5 dash. We will concentrate at this process 4 to 5 dash. 4 to 5 dash is an actual expansion process which is occurring in a cooling turbine. So, from this definition, you can easily tell that exit of the cooling turbine. This is the exit, 5 dash is the exit. So at this point, this is the temperature. If I say this is T5 dash, this is the exit of the temperature. So the definition of DART says that at this point, there should not be no moisture content. If there is no moisture content, then this will be the DART. This will be the DART. If I say T5 dash is a DART. Okay. If I say like a T DART. At this point, if there is no moisture content at 5 dash, then the temperature at 5.5 dash will be DART, T DART. Okay, now let's see what is the meaning of moisture condensation. What is the meaning of moisture condensation? We see this diagram, TS diagram of water. This is the water curve. Here this is the liquid line and here vapor curve. This is liquid curve and this is vapor curve. Dry saturated liquid, dry saturated vapor. And this is the critical point, you know very well. And this is the critical point. To understand the moisture content or moisture condensation, I have taken this diagram so that you can easily understand. But remember here, this process is going on at constant pressure. This is not related to this process because in cooling turbine, the process is occurring adiabatically, irreversibly, not isentropically. But in this case, air is at point this, DBT, means dry bulb temperature. If I say air is at dry bulb temperature, in air, moisture content is there. Moisture means water vapor is there. So if temperature of air is dry bulb temperature, then water vapor also have a temperature, dry bulb temperature. So at this point, water has a temperature, dry bulb temperature. As the water release heat, so temperature will reduce. In this case, you can see easily the water is releasing heat and temperature is reducing. In this process, temperature is going on reduced at constant pressure. Okay, so at this point, here water is in superheated state. You also remember this is superheated region, this is liquid plus vapor region, and this is liquid region. At this point, water is in superheated state at this area. Now, to understand the concept of moisture condensation, I have taken TS diagram for water curve. In water, there are three phases. This is liquid, this is liquid plus vapor, and this is superheating state, vapor region. So I consider this at this point, water is in superheated region. In air has two parts, dry air plus water vapor. Air has two parts, dry air and water vapor. So if air is at temperature, dry bulb temperature, this is DBT, dry bulb temperature. Then water also have the same temperature at this point. From this point, water will release heat. Sorry, not water, water vapor. Here is water is in superheated stage or superheated region. So at this point, the superheating stage of water, water will release heat. After releasing the heat, the water state is in superheating region. This will go to the dry state. This will go to the dry state. This is the dry vapor and this is the saturated liquid line. Okay, so after releasing the heat from this superheated form of water, water will reduce at this point, water will convert at this point in liquid. At this point, the superheated form of water will convert it into liquid form. So this point is called dew point. This point is called dew point. Dew point. So at this point, the temperature of water, if I say, it is the dew point temperature. Or if I say the temperature of water vapor at this point is dew point temperature. That means from this point, the water vapor will convert into liquid. So condensation is occurring. Condensation means vapor form will convert into liquid form. The same here, vapor form is converting into liquid form. So at this point, this is the dew point temperature. So see here, to prevent condensation during expansion in turbine, the dew point temperature and hence moisture content of the air should be very low. That means the dew point temperature, this is if dew point temperature is this one. Now, if up to this point there is no condensation, then this point will be dry, dot T dot, dry air rated temperature. Now consider in other way, if at this point condensation is occurring, suppose this was the case 1, if I say, now if I say that at case 2, I take at T5 dash condensation is occurring. If condensation is occurring, then moisture content will go into the cabin. Moisture will go into the cabin with the air. How we will see the concept of moisture condensation? Consider TS diagram I have drawn here. This is the water curve. This curve is the saturated liquid curve and this one is the saturated vapor curve. Here liquid form is there, in this region liquid plus vapor is there and this is vapor state, vapor region. This is for water. Okay, now friends, see, air has two component. Air has two component. What? Dry air plus water vapor. Air has two component, dry air and water vapor. So in water vapor, this is the water cup. So what is this? DBT. This is the dry bulb temperature. This is the dry bulb temperature of air. If it is for air, then temperature for water is also dry bulb temperature. Now, from this point, if water is releasing heat, this water vapor is releasing heat, then temperature will reduce. You see here, temperature is going to decrease. And at this point, this vapor is start to convert into liquid. So this is up to this point, vapor is there. After this, liquid will form. Vapor will convert into liquid. So liquid will form in this region. So this point is called dew point temperature. This point is called dew point temperature. The temperature at which water vapor starts to convert into liquid, that temperature is called dew point temperature. Okay, so let's see here. To prevent condensation during expansion in turbine, the dew point temperature and hence moisture content of air should be very low. That means this dew point temperature should be very low. If I say that this is the dew point temperature, if I say for this curve, this is the dew point temperature. So can you tell that this is the dew point temperature? It is very low. It is less than this T5 dash. So there is no problem. There is no problem in this process. If dew point temperature is here, then there is a problem. What problem? The turbine process will exit. Turbine process or expansion process will close up to this point and this up to this point. So moisture, and here the turbine is going, process is going on here. So moisture content of air will go into the cabin. That is not desirable. Okay, so to prevent condensation, the dew point temperature should be low. That means if I write here, the T dot should be greater than temperature of dew point. If I say equal to, then there is no problem. The T dot should be greater than or equal to dew point. If T dot is less than dew point temperature, then moisture will go into the cabin, and in that is the undesirable condition. Moisture will be harmful for the equipments, for aircraft systems. Okay, you know very well in aircraft that like PCBs are there, electronic items are there, that all these electronics items are required for the cooling. If moisture goes into that system, the electronic items may get damaged. And if moisture is more in the cabin, that is also uncomfortable situation for the human being. Okay, so the dew point temperature should be very, very low, so that condensation will not occur. Now, the concept of DART is used to compare different aircraft refrigeration cycle. I already explained that the DART will use for the comparison of all the different aircraft refrigeration cycle, which I explained in the previous video. Let's see how it is compared. Okay, let's see the comparison of all the system, all the aircraft refrigeration system with the help of DART. This is the curves. These curves are drawn on the T dot and Mach number. These curves are drawn on the axis T dot and Mach number. Okay. You see this curve is for the simple aircraft refrigeration system without evaporator. This is the simple aircraft refrigeration system. I have used short form. And this is the simple aircraft refrigeration system with evaporator. This is the bootstrap system. And this is bootstrap system with evaporator. This one is without evaporator. This is reduced ambient system. Reduced ambient system, reduced ambient aircraft system. And this is regenerative system. Okay. So, by looking all the curves, these are the some conclusions that first, as the DART is increasing, you see here, the DART is increasing, Mach number is also increasing. For SARS, DART is increasing, Mach number is increasing. For bootstrap system, P DART is increasing, Mach number is increasing. For regenerative system, DART is increasing, Mach number is increasing. Except this one. Based on these curves, there are some conclusions I have written here. First conclusion is that DART increase monotonically with Mach number. Friends, you see here, this is the SAR, simple air refrigeration system, and bootstrap refrigeration system, and regenerative system. For these three systems, if you see that as the Mach number is increasing, P DART is increasing. And this SAR SE and bootstrap system with evaporator, this is with evaporator. If evaporator is used, then as the Mach number is increasing, then T DART is decreasing. Except this RAS. RAS means reduced ambient system. The T DART is decreasing as the Mach number is increasing. Don't consider this one. Because these are the part of SARS and BSRS. In this we have used evaporator. In this also we have used evaporator. By using evaporator, T DART is decreasing with the Mach number. Okay, but main system are four system, na? SARS, BSS, REGSA and RAS. Okay, for all the four systems, SARS, BSS, REGS, simple aircraft refrigeration system, bootstrap system and regenerative system, T DART is increasing with the Mach number. Except reduced ambient system. Okay, it's clear? Now, simple system is adequate at low Mach number. You see here, SARS has low Mach number. If I say Mach number is like this, it is increasing and in this side it is reducing. For low Mach number, SARS is adequate. It can be used. Adequate means it can be used. Okay, for adequate Mach number, SARS can be used. At high Mach number, BSS or REGS is used. I have used short form. Please see here. At high Mach number, bootstrap system or regenerative system can be used. So, these are the comparison. This is the comparison of all the systems based on T DART and Mach number. Okay. Now, let's see here one more thing also. What is that? You see here 5-6. This is the refrigeration effect for this 5-6. If I say refrigeration effect, that is mass flow rate into Cp into T6 minus T5 dash. So here if I can write mass flow rate into Cp into T6 minus T DART. This is the cooling capacity or refrigeration effect or desired effect for this system. This will be the formula. So friends, in this video, we have seen the comparison of all the systems based on these curves, which are drawn between temperature, T DART and Mach number. In the next video, we will do some numericals on air refrigeration system. Okay, thanks for watching this video and have a good day.